Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen, taking a look at Excel 2010. You know, and actually Microsoft is calling it 2010. I can't get used to that. Excel 2010. One of the big problems with Excel 2007 was the ribbon, and people couldn't figure out where things were on the ribbon. You know, a lot of companies just didn't upgrade because they didn't want to have to retrain everybody, going from the old menu and toolbars to the new ribbon. And some things on the ribbon make sense, but there's some things that I still just don't understand, like, why is pivot table on the insert tab when clearly it belongs on the data tab? Well, finally, now, we have the ability that we can customize the ribbon very easily without doing any programming at all. So I take a look at the data tab here. I think the pivot table really goes between sort and filter and data tools. So we'll come up, we'll right click, customize the ribbon, and I'm going to expand data here. I'm going to add a new group, and I'll rename that group. I'll call it pivot. Click OK, and then over here on the left hand side, find all commands, and we'll go down alphabetically down to the P's and find pivot table. And we will add that to our group, and then finally I'll take my group and move it up between sort and filter and data tools. All right, click OK, and now finally we have pivot table exactly where it belongs. I could go back to the insert tab and remove it from here. In fact, as you can see, you can turn off entire ribbon tabs just by checking them or unchecking them. So, you know, there's our developer tab. It would be pretty cool. Now, it's going to be tedious, but what I imagine is going to happen is one guy in the company, the Excel go-to guy, is going to go through and figure out the right way for it to be, and then he can use import-export to save the file and pass it out to everyone in the accounting department or the finance department or something like that. And of course, by the time Excel 2010 comes out, I'm going to have the Mr. Excel customizations, the most common ones for data analysts out there, and I'll make that freely available, and I'm sure plenty of people will even come out with the customization that puts things back in the order of the original Excel 2003 menu, so that way just during the transition it'll be very easy to find things. This is a great improvement. Microsoft, frankly, I'm going to say they were a little bit arrogant in forcing everyone to live with the way they wanted things on the ribbon. It caused a lot of frustration, and the end result was not a large number of people went to 2007. Now that this feature's here, really, we can customize the ribbon, and there won't be the learning curve, plus a lot of great new features. So hopefully, more of us will be upgrading for Excel 2010. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.